So Biden, again, as I mentioned, announcing that they're going to release some oil. This is going to help cost. This could bring oil down temporarily to about $70 a barrel. That obviously is going to help some gas prices for a little bit of time. But, you know, that is only a Band-Aid on a much, much bigger problem. So what do we do when the 50 million barrels runs out, which is 5 days? 5 days. Okay, so what do we do? What do we do when that happens? Are we going to start pumping more? There's no more in the strategic reserve unless you want to just run it dry. Let's give Russia and China more ammunition. And the other thing about Russia and China, you know, I know they're doing everything to make sure the whole world is paying higher tax rates so that there's no competition for America paying astronomical taxes because they don't want companies leaving. Guess where they're going to go? They're going to go to Russia and China. Do you really think Russia and China are going to enforce these rules? You think there's other rogue nations out there that are going to support these rules? Do you think there are American companies that are going to say, I don't care where we go. I'll go wherever we got to go. But we're not going to pay. If we can save that 15% in taxes, we're going to save 15% in taxes, which is going to go directly to our bottom line, which is going to be good for our stockholders, good for our bottom line, good for profit, good for the company, good for growth. So why wouldn't we go there? If we can find a little peace in some part of Russia, we'll do it. We'll put something there and start over there. That's fine. We don't have a problem with it. Maybe we can cut a deal with Ireland. Maybe we can cut a deal with somebody else that desires to have economic growth in their country and that needs it real bad. But no, the politicians believe that's not going to happen. It is going to happen. They are going to start walking. They are going to start leaving. The stock market is going to start doing horribly. Expect to see if this, not soon, but the day after this bill gets passed in the Senate, assuming that there's still a 37% tax on capital gains, you can guarantee the last week of December is going to be nothing but selling. You talk about buying opportunities, stocks are going to drop like a rock because everybody's going to be selling out, taking their profits and paying their 15 or even 20% so they don't have to pay the 37%. You know, the worst part about this for me, and it's really the thing that is most aggravating, because let me just mention that for a majority of us, none of this is going to really dramatically impact us. It's not going to dramatically impact me. It's not going to dramatically impact a lot of other people. I just get furious that there are actually those people in America that are sitting in the poverty level or making $45,000, $50,000 a year, living okay. Maybe they live in a rural area or whatever. They're doing just fine. They're providing for their family. They're happy. They're working hard. They're going to get hurt. These people are the ones that are going to get hurt. The very people that put Biden into office are going to get hurt. Senior citizens are going to get decimated. They need total control over the senior citizens. They're going to get decimated. Count on it. We're going to have IRS, a lot more IRS agents. I do believe that a bill that they're going to be fighting for out of the Senate is going to include the same intrusions to our bank accounts that they took out in the House. They're going to get them back in there somehow, way, shape, or form. They're going to hope that it's going to fly under the radar enough to get the bill passed. Or Joe Manchin holds out and fights for the American people. Joe Manchin, Kyrsten Sinema, they're our only hope. It's unbelievable. It's just unbelievable. Hey, remember to click the subscribe button right here on the screen. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified when new content is added. And more importantly than anything, you don't want to miss all 3 live hours our financial issues every day from 9 to noon. And you can watch it on FISM.TV. That's FISM.TV.